We are walking to the altar of the Lord. We are walking to the altar of the Lord. We will all go together on the Lord's own day. We will go to the altar of the Lord. Come sing, come pray, come hear the Lord's holy word. We will all go together to the Lord's own table. We will go to the altar of the Lord. We are coming near the altar of the Lord. We are coming near the altar of the Lord. We will all come together on the Lord's own day. We will come to the altar of the Lord. Come praise, come thank, come lift your hearts to the Lord. We will all come near to the Lord's own table. We will come to the altar of the Lord.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. This mass is offered for the following intention: Archdiocese of Hyderabad, Bollaram Parish. This mass is offered by Divyavani TV Corpus Fund donors Pudot Ennaya and Fatima Mary. For Pudot Ennaya on his birthday, for good health and good future of Rajashekhar, Deepthi, Rihanna, Reva, Pratap Manohar, Sweta, Nishka, Srika and all family members. For the departed souls of Pudot Jojaya, Chinnamma, Mallavar Pulurdaya and Manikyam, and thanking the Lord for all the graces received. Together with this Mass, today's Rosary, Divine Mercy Chaplet, Word of God and Holy Hour are also offered for this family and their intentions. Let us pray for this family in a special way. And also let's remember and pray for all the donors of our TV channel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we are going to celebrate the birth of Jesus in a few hours from now, the church wants us to trust the Lord and see Him as someone who is gracious. And that is the meaning of the word John, about whose birth today we reflect in the Gospel. And by fulfilling His promise made to Zechariah and Elizabeth, God bestows this son, John the Baptist, and rightly he is named by God as John. That means God is gracious. And Christmas is the time when we celebrate the graciousness of God, the mercy of God, and the way He has kept His promises made in the Old Testament in sending His only Son to fulfill the promises and the prophecies. And many times we have failed to remember the graciousness of God, the kindness and mercies of God. And that's why, to celebrate these mysteries in a worthy manner, let us call to mind our sinfulness and ask for God's forgiveness, because He is gracious and full of compassion. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, and in my words,
in what I have done,
and in what I have failed to do,
through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
You have come to heal the contrite, Lord, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, as we see how the nativity of your Son according to the flesh draws near, we pray that to us, your unworthy servants, mercy may flow from your word, who chose to become flesh of the Virgin Mary and establish among us his dwelling. Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
I will send you Elijah the prophet before the day of the Lord comes. First reading, a reading from the book of Malachi, chapter 3, verses 1 to 4, and chapter 4, verses 5 to 6. The Lord God says this, "Behold, I send my messenger to prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple. The messenger of the covenant in whom you delight, behold, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. But who can endure the day of his coming, and who can stand when he appears? For he is like a refiner's fire and like fuller's soap. He will sit as a refiner and purifier of silver, and he will purify the sons of Levi and refine them like gold and silver, till they present right offerings to the Lord. Then the offering of Judah and Jerusalem will be pleasing to the Lord as in the days of the old and as in the former years. Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the great and terrible day of the Lord comes. And he will turn the hearts of fathers to their children and the heart of children to their fathers, lest I come and smite the land with a curse. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response. Stand erect, hold your heads high.
Stand erect, hold your heads high.
Because your liberation is close at hand.
Because your liberation is close at hand.
Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths. Make me walk in your truth and teach me. For you are my Savior. Your response. Stand erect, hold your heads high.
Stand erect, hold your heads high.
Because your liberation is close at hand.
Because your liberation is close at hand.
His ways are faithfulness and love for those who keep his covenant and will. The Lord's friendship is for those who revere him. To them he reveals his covenant. Your response. Stand erect, hold your heads high.
Stand erect, hold your heads high.
Because your liberation is close at hand.
Because your liberation is close at hand.
God come down on earth, alleluia. Touch our hearts and bring to birth, alleluia. Faith and hope and lasting love, alleluia. Word of God come down on earth. Speak to us the eternal word, alleluia. You who brought all things to life, alleluia. Word that came from heaven to die, alleluia. Speak to us, eternal word. Word made flesh, we long for you, alleluia. Word that speaks the Father's love, alleluia. Word that sends the Spirit blessed, alleluia. Word made flesh, we long for you.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter the first, verses from 57 to 66. Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. Chapter 1, verses from 57 to 66. Now the time came for Elizabeth to be delivered, and she gave birth to a son. And her neighbors and kinsfolk heard that the Lord had shown great mercy to her, and they rejoiced with her. And on the eighth day they came to circumcise the child, and they would have named him Zechariah after his father. But his mother said, "Not so, he shall be called John." And they said to her, "None of your kindred is called by this name." And they made signs to his father, inquiring what he would have him called. And he asked for a writing tablet and wrote, "His name is John." And they all marveled, and immediately his mouth was opened and his tongue loosed, and he spoke, blessing God. And fear came on all their neighbors, and all these things were talked about through all the hill country of Judea. And all who heard them laid them up in their hearts, saying, "What then will this be? Will this child be?" For the hand of the Lord was with him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, in the first reading, which is taken from the book of Malachi. Malachi, this book is found as the last book in the Old Testament. So in this last book in the Old Testament from Malachi, Yahweh says, "I will send you Elijah the prophet before the day of the Lord comes." Therefore, Yahweh is assuring that before the Messiah comes, a prophet will be sent to prepare his path. And in Matthew chapter 17, verse 13, we hear Jesus identifying John the Baptist as the prophet Elijah, which means the prophecy made in the book of Malachi that someone, a prophet, will be sent before the Messiah comes. His name is Elijah. This particular prophecy is fulfilled in and through John the Baptist. And today the gospel explains us the scenario of naming John the Baptist. The famous writer Shakespeare, in his Romeo and Juliet, says, "What is in a name? A rose would, by any other name, would smell the same. Whether you call rose by rose, or if you keep it another name, the smell would not change. It will still smell the same." That means name is nothing, anything significant. But in the Bible, it is not so. In the Bible, a name is given according to the work, according to the purpose, and according to one's calling. In other words, a name would indicate my life. It is the summary of my life. That's why people today, they try to find different names which have no meanings. But then in the Bible, a person is named according to the purpose for which he is created. For example, God decided through angel what name should be given to Jesus. That's why the angel told Mother Mary that he will be called Jesus, because God saves his people. He is the savior. And therefore, as the name Jesus indicates, Jesus came into the world to save us, to save the people. That's why the name was already decided upon by God himself. And in the same way, there are three categories of people today in the scenario of naming John the Baptist. First of all, there were the neighbors of Zechariah and Elizabeth. You know, they thought that he would be named Zechariah following his daddy. And then the second person is Elizabeth. When Elizabeth was asked what name this boy should be given, she said John. And also the third person, Zechariah, at the time he was dumb as a punishment. He was not able to speak, but then he took a writing tablet and then he clearly said that his son should be called John. So among these three categories, one category, the neighbors, they wanted to go by tradition. Usually, the sons have the names of fathers. Therefore, they thought he should be given Zechariah. But then, Zechariah and Elizabeth, they wanted to call him John. John means God is gracious. Therefore, this name, John, reflects how God has been gracious at the birth of John. Because Elizabeth was a barren woman and she was blamed by everybody because she was not able to conceive a child. God showed his graciousness to Elizabeth and Zechariah, especially to Elizabeth. Because if you don't conceive a child, it is the woman that was blamed more than the man. Therefore, God was gracious to Elizabeth and Zechariah. And the gospel says that immediately, without delay, what happened when Zechariah wrote that his name should be John, immediately his mouth was opened, he started speaking. You see, for 9 months almost, Zechariah was dumb. But then when he decided to call his son as John, Zechariah, who doubted the angel at that time, now he has full belief, full trust that whatever God has promised would take place. And that's why he remembered that his son should be called John as previously told. Therefore, he received this miracle and healing that he started to speak again. Therefore, brothers and sisters, today, we reflecting upon the name of John should always believe that God is gracious. And at Christmas, it is the graciousness of God that we celebrate. God became human not only to save the world, but more than that, he became human because he has loved us. God so loved the world that he sent his only son. So that is the primary purpose of the birth of Jesus, is to show his love and graciousness to the world. And today, we have to remember always that God is gracious to us. Once there was this atheist who did not believe in the existence of God, and he challenged a believer. And the challenge was this. You know, you are saying there is God. And my challenge is, if there is God, let him strike on my head now. If there is God, let him strike me on my head and let me be dead. That was the challenge. And of course, nothing happened. Nobody striked him on his head and he was alive. But then the believer who took up the challenge, he said, "My dear man, you proved not only that God exists, but you proved that God is gracious. Because God is gracious, you were not struck on your head. brothers and sisters, in this beautiful season, when we celebrate, when we are preparing ourselves to celebrate the mercies of God, let us remember that God is gracious in spite of whatever is going on right now in the world. Amen. Let's all stand and make known to God our prayers and petitions. God, our loving Father, we pray for the Catholic Church, for the Pope, the priests, the bishops and all, the nuns and the baptized laity, that we always remember and celebrate your mercies, your graciousness, no matter what. And we, like Zechariah and Elizabeth today in naming John, as they remembered that you are a faithful God, that you will keep up your promises, open our hearts to understand this truth, no matter what we are going through. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for all the donors of our TV channel, because of whose generosity we are able to take your word of love to every corner of the world. Lord, we ask you to bless them so that they may continue to believe and trust in you. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for the people that are infected and affected by COVID-19, especially in its new form. We pray that it may be contained before it spreads to other parts of the world, that all the scientists and doctors who have been working and struggling to come up with a medicine and vaccine may be inspired by your power, so that we may come to normalcy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a few moments, let's make known to God our prayers and petitions in the silence of our hearts. We make these prayers and the prayers in our hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen. I give to use for thee, for yours are torn from Calvary. Those hands that you are covered straight were nailed that day for me to save. No greater gift can ever be than that which God did give to me. For long ago he gave to us the greatest gift we'll ever receive. My heart I pledge to love for thee, for yours did break on Calvary. A heart that knew no love and death, my hands I give its love to shed. No greater gift can ever be than that which God did give to me. For long ago he gave to us the greatest gift we'll ever receive.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church.
May this oblation, by which divine worship in its fullness has been inaugurated for us, be our perfect reconciliation with you, O Lord, that we may celebrate with minds made pure the nativity of our Redeemer, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thumma Bala, our Archbishop, Bishop Pula, the Archbishop-elect, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of God's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen. Prayer of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come into my heart spiritually. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself to you wholly. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Thou art the potter, I am the clay. Mold me and make me after thy will. Try me, Master, today. Whiter than snow, Lord, wash me just now, as in thy presence humbly I bow. Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Wounded and weary, help me, I pray. Power, all power, surely is thine. Touch me and heal me, Savior divine.
My dear brothers and sisters, tomorrow, that is 24th evening at 8 p.m., Divivani is broadcasting Galipatam, a movie about family and communications in Telugu. And from 10:30, we have the live telecast of the Mass from Fatima Cathedral, Warangal, the Christmas Midnight Mass. So please prepare yourself and please participate in the Mass from your homes. Let us pray. Grant your peace, O Lord, to those you have nourished with these heavenly gifts, that we may be ready with lighted lamps to meet your dearly beloved Son at his coming, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
and with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our holy mass is ended. Let us go in peace and joy of Christ.
Thanks be to God. God's love is the key, turning each every way. God is love, all is there. Jesus came to show him, that mankind might know him. Sing aloud, loud, loud, sing aloud, loud, loud. God is good, God is truth, God is beauty, praise him. None can see God above, all have here meant to love. Thus may we God but move, finding him in others, holding all men brothers. Sing aloud, loud, loud, sing aloud, loud, loud. God is good, God is truth, God is beauty, praise him. Jesus lived here for men, strove and died, rose again. Rules our hearts now as then, for he came to save us, by the truth he gave us. Sing aloud, loud, loud, sing aloud, loud, loud. God is good, God is truth, God is beauty, praise him.